I'm going to do what I'm getting very, very, very used to doing, which is performing and presenting at the same time. My work has been inspired greatly by Kathleen Lingertz. And again, an amazing moment to see how she's transferred her work on Cecil Alamin in Ghana to applying it to connect with art practices here in America. Similarly, I have been looking at the subject of improvisation and applying it to my own work with contemporary artists in London and in California. So what is it, this thing about improvisation? Well, it's preponderant, not only in African forms, but I was considering that there was something particular, very, very particular, about what I was seeing across the diaspora as well as the continent. And so, examining the ideas, I've come up with a schema. I've come up with a plan to be able to understand the foundation, the matrix that's underneath this creativity that is bountiful and never seems to come to an end. So I've called it embodiology. In a sense, it's my translation of Cecil Alamin. It is a multi, poly, cross integration of many forms of beingness. And so today I'm just going to focus a little bit more on the thing that I really went to Ghana to examine, which was time, rhythm. What is this thing that is constantly misappropriated? So I've discovered that rhythm is not a thing of just dividing time, but it's a sensation that comes from the inside. And it's only through connecting with what's on the inside that we can actually experience time. In a way that is complex and integrates with those of others. So, critical in airway music is the bell. And it was through the bell that a dancer told me structures everything that's in the music. So without the bell, without knowledge of the feeling and the timing of the bell, there was and is no understanding. So we're going to see what is inside this idea of the bell. It's a pattern that musicians and dancers and singers use to connect the various levels of the music. And there is no difference between music and dance and song. As you saw or may not have seen yet, in many languages, the word for music, dance, event is the same word. What do you mean it's the same word? Well, it makes no sense to them to divide. And if we divide and analyze in this separated way, we get false outcomes. So we kind of have to resist our own preferences for dividing things in order to get to the center of where their truth is. So, the bell pattern from a dance that's called Atsuya Togo. Can you hear the time that's under my step? Can you clap it?
Thank you.
without there being a dilemma. Suddenly I'm thrown into a place where I'm really off balance. And actually, that's what it felt like for me. In Ghana, you're free to go. For a very long time, until one day, I was in a drumming class, and rather than try to keep up with the intensity of learning the various patterns, I decided to just be, place my sticks on the drum head, and close my eyes. And for the next 15 minutes, I just listened, but my whole body listened from an interior place. And each different drum, the kiddie, the kota, the bell, the master drum, all mapped, interwove, and met me. The shakari, I could feel in the crown of my head, and the bell somewhere here, the kiddie here, the bass drum in my pelvis, and a swirling of all of this time, all of these connections of time. And then there was a moment where it just sounded like a hum. And there was no sea of differentiation. It was a hum. And I was in this cavern, I was in this chamber, and I was in heaven. It just was a place that everything was complete. I did not want the song to end. I literally was just floating. Later, I spoke to the master drummer and explained this sensation, this journey that I went on. And he said, oh, you were very close to being in that other worldly place, that place where you make that other connection. In fact, he said I was there, but he just didn't want to name it. And it was a place where there was no differentiation, there was no separation between me and anyone else that was hearing, feeling, connect. It was one om. And then he went on to explain to me that the drums speak, and went on to enunciate the grammar of the drum. He said, we have notes in drumming. Go, gedi, gadi, gadra. And each one he enunciated had a different tone, a different facet to it. And he said, then we use these notes as we are playing to make variations. And these variations are what the audience then has to translate to understand what we are saying now, and the dancers have to then interpret what they hear. So my Anglophone ear had incredible problems finding that airway enunciation. But after that moment in that drumming class, it got better. My ability to be able to tune into the interior, and it was from an internal connection that I was able to make that. I'm just going to show you a short video, very quickly, of the kind of drumming I was exposed to. And my notion of call and response shifted very much through this experience. Thank you. idea of call and response, I was like, where's the call versus the response? This just all happened too quickly. For my eye and for my ear and for my... It's about the space. And believe it or not, there is space. Because each time another layer or a new pattern is created, it's done through identification of that space. And then a creation that models itself through that space. So as I was trying to say, there were, unless they were playing the same size drum, no two musicians are playing the same thing, and those patterns are asymmetric. They are not these simple patterns that just reoccur. They are very complex, very complex. And it's through understanding that rhythm is not only about the time, it's about feeling the space and the suspension that enables you to connect and be able to then speak to that space, to be able to create, to be able to innovate, to be able to occupy a space where you're actually communicating with others. And that modality was very crucial for me to then apply and have continued on my journey through improvisation to consider the role in which language is not only the spoken language, but it also this oral language and the balance. We talk about balance is also this oral balance, which is shifting. And balance is all about change. And that is what's going constantly through this space. Change and responsivity through a really deep level of investing in communicating. I know the time is moving on, so I'm going to wrap it up there and see where we are with questions.